Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome to the presentation of the 2022-2023 Homecoming Court chosen by the student body of Gosnell High School.
This year's freshman princess is Candy Grace Riggs. She is the daughter of Derek and Brittany Riggs. She is a member of the GJHS cheer team, GHS competition cheer team, and freshman class president. After graduation, she plans to attend college to pursue a career in pediatric endocrinology in hopes of one day finding a cure to type 1 diabetes. It being special to her due to friends Aaron and Stella Sanchez. The person she admires most is her Aunt Corey because she is kind, hardworking, loving, funny, gives the best advice, and reminds Kendi to be herself no matter what. Kendi's favorite hobbies are shopping with her mom, annoying her dad and brother, hanging out with friends, spending time with Cam and Stella and her boyfriend, and watching Gilmore Girls. Her words of advice are to take your problems to God and lay them at His feet. 1 Peter 5:7, cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you.
This year's freshman prince is Kylan Young. He is the son of Tiara Mitchell and Robert Young. He is a member of the Gosnell Junior High football team, and after graduation, Kylan plans to play football at the college level. The person he admires most is his older brother, Kadarius Young, because he works hard for what he has, even when he doesn't have anything. Kylan's hobby is playing football. His words of advice are, all good things come to those who work hard.
Freshman, Candy Riggs.
And Kylan Young.
This year's sophomore princess is Nicoline Hempson. She is the daughter of Brooke Rasmussen and Quartz Hempson. After high school, she goes and doing what she has always wanted to do. Nicoline's hobbies are going to Walmart, being social, and hanging out with her friends. Her words of advice are, all you touch and all you see is your life will ever be.
This year's sophomore prince is Percy Wright. He is the son of Percy Wright Sr. and Felicia Perkins. He is a member of the GHS football, basketball, and track team, and is involved in youth ministry. After high school, he plans to play football at the college level while studying pre-law. Following college, Percy would like to go pro in the NFL, but if not, would like to enroll in law school to become a lawyer or a sports agent. The person he admires most is his cousin, Taryn Cox, because he is a successful young entrepreneur. Percy's favorite hobby is playing football. Percy's words of advice are, you will never believe in yourself if you keep comparing yourself to others. Also, Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future.
Sophomores, Nicoline Hempson.
And Percy Wright.
This year's junior princess is Keegan Manrique. She is the daughter of Misty and Joey Manrique. After high school, she plans to go to college in California to study game development and design, and hopes to become a gaming influencer and make a name for herself in the future. The person she admires most is her brother because of how hardworking, fearless, caring, and how he has always been her protector. Keegan's hobbies are playing video games with her friends all night, editing post-game recordings, and hiking with her dad. Her words of advice are, you cannot make people love you by giving them more of what they already don't appreciate.
This year's junior prince is Griffin Sosa. He is the son of Mike and Christy Jacquees. He is a member of the GHS FFA. After high school, he plans to get a degree in history and then go into law school. The person he admires most is his dad, Mike Jacquees, because he has shown and taught him how to be a respectful young man and for being the father he didn't have to be. Griffin's favorite hobbies are going to the gym, hanging out with Nathan, Jordan, Javante, and Easton, annoying his sister Gabby, and cooking. Griffin's words of advice are, look both ways before crossing the street.
Juniors, Keegan Menariki.
And Griffin Sosa.
This year's senior princess is Desiree Robinson. Desiree is a daughter of Crystal Robinson and Gerald Hopkins. She is a part of the GHS cheer team and Beta Club. After graduation, she plans to attend Texas Southern University and pursue something in the medical field. Further down the line, she hopes to possibly become something in the fashion industry. Desiree admires her mother most because no matter what, she tries to make everything she needs and wants happen. She's the hardest working person she knows. Her hobbies are cheering, reading, designing, making clothes, watching anime, working out, and sleeping. Desiree's words of advice are, always step out and be different. You're going to have haters regardless. Give them something else to hate on.
This year's senior prince is Reed Shelton. He is the son of Kristen Parker and Joshua Shelton. He is a member of the Gosnell High School's football, basketball, and baseball team. His plans after graduation are to attend college and further his baseball career. The person Reed admires most is his pop. He has taught him everything he knows and to always work hard. His hobbies are playing football, hanging out with friends, and going to the lake with friends and family. Reed's words of advice are, behind every great man is a woman rolling her eyes.
Seniors, Desiree Robinson.
And Reed Shelton.
This year's homecoming queen is Logan Tilly. Logan is the daughter of Stephanie Carr and Brian Tilly. She's the captain of the GJHS cheer team, co-captain of the Lady Pirates softball team, Beta Club, student council president, senior class president, class favorite, and a fire marshal. Her plans after graduation are to attend the University of Central Arkansas or Arkansas State University and major in business. She then plans to attend cosmetology school. The person Logan admires most is her mom because she handles everything with grace and confidence. She takes on more than most people can handle and makes it look easy. Her hobbies are cheering on the Pirates, singing happy birthday to Jinky Poo, hang out with her friends and family, and hitting curves. Logan's words of advice are, always remember tomorrow is a new day. Making mistakes is a part of life. Saying no is okay. Not everyone is like you, and beauty and strength come from within.
This year's homecoming king is Gavin Norris. Gavin is the son of Larissa and Scott Norris. After graduation, he plans to attend Arkansas Northeastern College to continue working on his computer programming degree. Plan for him. Gavin's hobbies are gaming, reading, and being with his friends and cousins. His words of advice are, don't be stupid or foolish, and don't be a dummy. Always try to be nice to everyone.
The 2022 Homecoming King and Queen, Logan Tilly and Gavin Norris.
The crown bearers for this year's royalty presentation are Estella Camille Sanchez and Knox Christian Foster.
Stella Sanchez is the daughter of Sandy and Ann Sanchez. She is in kindergarten at Gosnell Elementary. After high school and college, she wants to be the doctor that discovers the cure to type 1 diabetes and own a doggy daycare. The person she admires most is Candy Riggs because she plays with her a lot. Stella loves to go to Chloe Smith's house, tumble, swim, and do her mom's makeup. She also loves to bother her sister Cameron, and play golf with her dad. Stella's words of advice are, always be kind and play with all kids.
Knox Foster is the son of Christian and Amber Foster. He is also in kindergarten here at Gosnell. He is a member of WC Kids at Wellspring Church. He also plays baseball, soccer, basketball, and attends ninja class. His plans after graduation are to become a police officer or a sheriff. The person he admires most is his daddy, because he takes good care of him and his mommy. Knox enjoys playing on the monkey bars at school, going to the trampoline park with his mommy and daddy, and drawing the Indominus Rex, dinosaurs, and dragons. His words...
Ladies and gentlemen, please give a final round of applause for the Gosnell High School Homecoming Court of 2022. All right, Gosnell Pirate fans, we'd like to welcome you to JWRA Stadium. If the King and Queen, or the Homecoming Royalty, would allow me to get started, they would like to welcome all the Gosnell alumni. Pirate fans, if you would, stand and face the north end of the field, and we're going to do the Pledge of Allegiance. And then right after that, the Gosnell High School Band will be playing our national anthem. Then right after that, we'll have one moment of silence, closed by a word of prayer. So if you would, let's stand and face the flag, please, and repeat after me, or join me. I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now our Gosnell High School Band for the national anthem. Great job, and if you would join me in 1 minute of silence. Thank you.
Let us pray. Father, we are so eternally grateful for your grace, your love, your mercy on us. I pray for our teams as they take the field tonight. We pray for a great game of football. Lord, keep us all safe as we leave this place. And as we know and remember that October is a time that we reflect on breast cancer awareness, we're thankful for the memories of those who may have passed from this deadly disease. But also we pray for courage, strength, and healing for those who are. We pray for your touch. We pray for your healing. And we just pray for the encouragement of family and friends for walking beside each person dealing with breast cancer. So, Father, thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus. And we celebrate your love and your grace. For it's in his name I pray. Amen.
Good evening, football fans. Welcome to JWRA Stadium, where the Gosnell Pirates will be hosting the Trumann Wildcats. Going to start off with tonight's roster for the Wildcats. Number one, Xavier Whitman. Number two, Murphy Williams. Number three, Cade Hatton. Number four, Coda Cameron. Number five, Eli Ebbett. Number six, Rico Hunt. Number seven, Jake Osmond. Number eight, Tony Postel, Jr. Number nine, Matthew Swan. Number 10, Braden DeSaul. Number 11, Carson Smith. Number 12, Gavin Greenwell. Number 15, Parks McNair. Number 17, Aiden Hammonds. Number 20, Jay. Number 21, Preston Wood. Number 22, Gavin Morgan. Number 14, Kyler Lumpkin. Number 27, Jameson Barnhill. Number 30, Peyton Callahan. Number 33, David Hodges. Number 51, Efren Garcia. Number 52, Evan Trout. Number 53, Keenan Swan. Number 58, Justin Price. Number 64, Blake. Number 66, Andrew Short. Number 69, Victor Gutierrez. Number 72, Thomas Chavera. Number 73, Brody McDaniel. Number 74, Zane Price. Number 77, Aiden McCall. Number 80, Evan Bishop. Number 84, Azari Thigpen. Number 88, Efren Garcia. Number 54, Alejandro Garcia. And number 56, Jonathan Vasquez. And now for your Gosnell Pirate lineup. Number one, Floyd Williams. Number two, Kadarian Partee. Number three, Cam Williams. Number four, Carson Talley. Number five, Reed Shelton. Number seven, Makai King. Number eight, Xavier Lewis. Number nine, Brandon Razor. Number 10, Chad Stewart. Number 11, Trent Middleton. Number 12, Percy Wright. Number 13, Daniel Smith. Number 15, Caleb Richmond. Number 16, Stephen McDay. Number 17, Bryce White. Number 18, Elijah Donerson. Number 19, Manuel Ahano. Number 20, Sebastian Laura. Number 21, Sid Laura. Number 25, Bryson Garner. Number 27, Jason Shepard. Number 28, Devin Spicer. Number 39, Mason Moore. Number 40, Christian Jackson. Number 41, Charles Kinnamore. Number 44, Jamarian Swanigan. Number 45, Caden Reed. Number 50, Sloan Harrison. Number 56, Javonte Williams. Number 57, Ahmad Turner. Number 65, Peyton Stegall. Number 71, Elijah Brown. Number 72, Connor Wilson. Number 73, Riley Grisham. Number 74, Trey Guy. And number 77, Don Willing. Tonight's coaches for the Pirates: Colton Humble, assistant coach. Spencer Appel, assistant as well. Aaron Coots, assistant. Defensive coordinator, Michael Lewis. And head coach, Lewis Ernest. The referees for tonight's game, back judge, Billy Beach. Line judge, Mike Tennant. Head linesman, Paul Good. Umpire, Alan Reynolds. Referee, Lamonte Harper. Tonight's 4-1 Pirates hosting the 3-2 Wildcats. Welcome, Wildcat fans. Captains for the Wildcats, number 77, Aiden McKay, number 27, Jamison Barnhill, and number 3, Cade Hatton. For the Pirates, number 39, Mason Moore, number 7, Makai King, number 8, Xavier Lewis, and number 28, Devin Spicer. Like Trumann has won the toss, and they are deferring to the second half.
All right, Gals and Pirate fans, are you ready for some football? Well, we encourage everyone and anyone to go down to the Spirit Line and show some love to our Pirates, especially our alumni. I know I've seen a few down there. How about Mr. Russell Leggett? I know it's been a minute since you played a homecoming football game, but I've seen several others down there as well. Let's show some love for our Gosnell Pirates. Yeah, we call them out here at Gosnell. Alright, let's get on your feet, Pirate fans! Correction for tonight's Gosnell Pirate football team is Charles K.A. Kennemore. He is number 69 tonight. in place of his traditional number 41. Back beat for the Pirates, number one, Floyd Williams. Number eight, Xavier Lewis. And number 12, Percy Wright. Kicking off for the Wildcats is number eight, Tony Pesquera. Kick out of bounds, midfield, that'll be a flag. To have it on their own 48, first and 10. Little trickery by our Pirates. Pass over to him. Second down with 10. Pirates and Shelton draw them off sides. Be a 5-yard penalty. Suck it down in about 5. Pass kicked by number 12. Number 12 is Gavin Greenwell. A couple of flags on the play after the interception. Against the Pirates and waved off by the Wildcats. The flying. So the Wildcats have the ball on their own 42. First down and 10. Pirate defense taking the field. Number three, Cade Hampton on the carry. Brought down by number eight, Xavier Lewis. First down for the Wildcats. Ball can be spotted on the Pirate 36-yard line. Covered by the Wildcats. Lost a couple of yards, took it down and 12. By number two, Murphy Williams, first out of bounds. Somewhere around the 35-yard line, 36-yard line. It'll be fourth and long for the Wildcats in Pirate territory. Good job, defense. Close. We got to see where the referee spots it. Oh, he's moving the chains, it looks like. First down, Wildcats. Ball spotted on the Pirate 26-yard line. Let's go defense. Let's get them motivated, Pirate fans. Ball spotted on the 19. It's going to be second down about three. Good job, Pirate fans. Wildcats stuttering up the middle. Host of Pirates in on the tackle. So it's going to be third and a couple. Third and about 3 yards. All right, Pirate fans, show them some love here. Go defense! Looks short, but we have to wait and see what the referee, where he spots the ball. Fourth and short. Fourth and about a yard. Let's go, Pirate fans. We need to help them out here. Defense. Shepard on the tackle. Looks like he barely gets it. He gets the first down. Ball should be spotted on the 15-yard line. Clock running. Stopped by number 69, Charles K.A. Kenmore. Referee signals touchdown, Wildcats. By number 2, Murphy Williams. Offsides against the Pirates. It appears that the Wildcats will be going for a two-point conversion here. Half the distance to the goal, so it'll be on the yard, 1.5 yard line. Great job, great defense brought down by number 4, Carson Talley. 2-point conversion denied. 5:47 to go in the first. Pirates 0, Wildcats 6. Still a lot of game left.
Your game day soundtrack is game time. Thank you.
Number 25 on the kickoff return for the Pirates. The ball's going to be spotted on the Pirate 47-yard line. First and 10. Let's get this offense rolling, Pirates. Floyd Williams on the carry. Gain of a couple, maybe three. Second and 7. Start against the Pirates. That'll bring them back 5 yards and replay the third down or second down. Lloyd Williams on the carry. He gets outside down near the 48-yard line. Picks up 7 of those yards back. So it's going to be 3rd and about 8. Start against the Pirates. Bring them back 5 yards and replay the down. Timeout, Pirates. From Chilton to Williams, complete. Ball's going to be spotted on the Wildcat 45. It's going to be fourth and just a short couple. Direct snap to Williams, and let's see where the referee spots it here. He's moving the chains, so that's a Gosnell Pirate. That's so good to say that. First one in 90. Straight up the deck. About 8 yards. Pirates getting some momentum here. Ball's going to be spotted on the 35-yard line. Second down in about 2. Carry again, Floyd Williams. Ball's going to be spotted on the 34-yard line. Third and about a yard. Course, Williams. That's going to be enough for a Gosnell Pirate. Great job, Pirate fans. Ball spotted on the 31-yard line. Floyd takes the snap direct. Gets all the way down to the 22-yard line. Carrying a couple of Wildcats with him. The ball is going to be spotted on the 23-yard line. Pirates knocking on the door for a score. Williams again gets across the 20. That's going to be enough for a Gosnell Pirate. Great job. Fans, that concludes the first quarter. Chilton to number 18, Elijah Donerson. And the pass, and Donerson gets down to the 3-yard line, or maybe the 4-yard line. That's first and goal. Pirates knocking on the door. Referee signals touchdown, Pirates! And of course, number one, Floyd Williams. Two-point conversion just falls short. Tie ball game here in Gosnell, Arkansas, with 11 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the second quarter. Number 18 kicking off for the Wildcats. I don't have his number up here, and that beat is Elijah Donerson kicking off. Seven for the Wildcat, Jake Osmond. And the kickoff return brought down by number 4, Carson Talley, and number 28, Devin Spicer. The Wildcats will have the ball on their own 40-yard line, first and 10. Pirate defense on the field. Defense stiffens up here. Number 69, Dawes. They get Kenna Moore again. Complete to Cody Hatton, stopped short by number 39, Mason Moore. Third and about a yard, though, Pirate fans, here for the media. Third down.
Defense.
See where forward progress gets him. Referee stopping the clock too. Referee signals first down Wildcats. Ball's going to be spotted on the 50-yard line. Pirate defense going to let them in your area. Mason Moore and number 27, Jason Shepherd on the stop. Minimal gain, second down at about 9.5. Pass intended for number 15, Parker McNair, stopped by number 8, Xavier Lewis. So it's going to bring up third and long, Pirate fans, defense. Third and long. Wildcats. Ball carrier got brought down by number 21, Sid Laura, and number 8, Xavier Lewis. It's going to be fourth and long for the Wildcats, and it appears the Wildcats will be going for it, Pirate fans. Defense. Floyd Williams. The punt returner gets all the way down to the 42-yard line for the Pirates. So the Pirates have good field position from their own 42, first down and 10.
8:05 to go in the second quarter. Course forward, Williams up the gut. 6-yard pickup for the Pirates. Maybe a 7-yard, or close. Second down and a little over 3. So the ball spotted on the Pirate 49. That's going to be enough for a Gosnell Pirate. And then some. Pirates into Wildcat territory now on their 44-yard line. Williams on the carry, but there's flag on the field. Holding, I believe, against the Pirates. So they'll bring them back, and they'll replay the down. It's going to bring the ball back to the Pirate 32-yard line. Replay the down. It's first and long for the Pirates. Calls a timeout here with 6:38 to go in the second quarter. From Jeff Williams. First and forever turns into a touchdown.
How about them Pirates? All right, we'll attempt a two-point conversion here. Referee signals a little short on the two-point conversion, but with 6:24 to go in the second quarter, Gosnell Pirates 12, Trumann Wildcats 6. Donaldson kicking off for the Pirates. Osmond on the kickoff return, brought down by number 39, Mason Moore. And number 21, Sid Laura, was in on the tackle as well. The Wildcats will have the ball on their own 41-yard line. First down and 10. Pirate defense taking the field. Let's go, Come on, move. Eli Edit on the carry, brought down by number 4, Carson Talley, and number 7, Mackay King. Second down and a couple for the Wildcats. Ball started on the 49. Number 5, Evans on the carry up the gut. Let's see where the referee spots the ball. Oh, it's first down, referee signals for the Wildcats. Ball is spotted on the Pirate 48. Let's go, defense. Hold him. Host of tackles in, or excuse me, host of Pirates in on the tackle. Number 69, Charles Kimmore. And number 4, I believe, Carson Talley. And number 8, Xavier Lewis. Second and about 7. Pass overthrown. So it's going to bring up third down and long for the Wildcats. Defense, Pirates, defense. Loud and proud, cheerleaders. Sounding good. Referee signals the catch is good and inbounds, so that's going to put the Wildcats down near the Pirate 29-yard line. First down. Carry, no go, says number 56 for the Pirates, and that's Javonte Williams. There's a flag, and it's against the Wildcats. Holding. That's going to march the ball back down to the 42-yard line, the Pirate 42-yard line. So it's going to be first and long forever for the Wildcats. Pass batted away by Shepherd. Second and long for the Wildcats. Incomplete, overthrown. So that's going to bring up third and long. Pirate fans need to hold them with 3 minutes and 58 to go in the half. Defense. Referee calls timeout, Pirates. Pass intended for number 12, but incomplete. Fourth and long. Pirate defense, let's stand up. Great job, number 27. Shepard and Jason Shepard in the backfield. Bad snap for the punter. And Shepard takes advantage of it. The Pirates will have the football in. Well, there's a. Pirates will have the football in Wildcat territory on the 48-yard line or close. First and 10. Yard line or close. That's going to be that third Gosnell Pirate. And then some with 3:39 to go in the half. Pirates are knocking on the door of the score. For a score. Flag on the field, false start against the Pirates. That'll bring them back 5 yards and replay the down. Again, commit down to the 18-yard line. Second down and about 2 for the Pirates. Joseph Williams gets away, but he's forced out of bounds. So it's going to be 3rd and about 4. The ball's going to be spotted on the 20-yard line. Thought Fort Travis got him, but he is going to be spotted short, 4th and about, half a yard maybe, or inches. All right, that's enough for a Gosnell Pirate. Great drive. Start against the Pirates. Bring them back 5 yards, replay the down. pass from Preet. Shelton to number 10, Chad Stewart. And that's going to be enough for a Gosnell Pirate. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. Hey, it's not. It's second and it's my bad. I got excited. It's second down, though. It's pretty good. Ball start against the Pirates again. Signals the referee, so let's bring them back 5 yards. Second down, about 12. 1:28 to go. So close. Pass attempt for part two. Third and 12 for the Pirates. Ball is spotted on the 13-yard line. He's going to be knee down somewhere near the 10. Incomplete. All right, 36 seconds to go in a half. Wildcats will take over on downs, deep in the their own territory. Pirate defense taking the field. Wildcats, brought down by number one, Floyd Williams. Pick up about 6 yards, second down and four. The ball's going to be spotted on the 21-yard line, or excuse me, the 16-yard line. Wildcats run out to the outside, brought down by number 21, Sid Laura, and that is going to do it for the first half. Gosnell Pirates 12, to the Wildcats 6. Stick around for the great halftime activities.
taking the field. How about a big round of applause for your Lady Pirates? A big round of applause for your Lady Pirate Cheer Squad. Joining you next on the field for your halftime entertainment, a big round of applause for the Lady Pirate Dance Team. Technical difficulty. He's going to restart here. Next on the field will be the Gosnell Pirate Marching Band. Thank you.
And now to continue your halftime entertainment, the award-winning Gosnell Pirate Marching Band. Drum major Jonathan Mayberry, is your band ready? Take the field, Jonathan. Let's do it. A cheer for the soloists. Good job. Thank you. Let's hear it again for the Gosnell Pirate Marching Band. The Gosnell Pirate Marching Band will be going to Paraboo Marching Contest on October 22nd. That's right down the road. We're looking forward to all the support we can get. October 22nd. You can get with band kids to find out the time. Nice job, Ben. Ladies and gentlemen, if I may have your attention, if you have lost a cell phone, it is at the concession stand, and you must be able to identify and unlock it. So once again, if you have lost a cell phone, it is at the concession stand, and you must be able to identify and unlock it. Thank you.
call it dirty. There is no place in my prayer, and it's just being worthy. Hurting me ways, cause I say pray for a please. When you was praying, if you think that you ready for me, so who's ready now?
Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention again, tomorrow night at 6 o'clock is an event that you do not want to miss. The Gosnell High School cheerleaders are sponsoring the Cheer for the Cure. This is to benefit the Relay for Life. There are several dance and cheer teams that will be here tomorrow participating. And again, you do not want to miss the event. Some of the schools that will be here tomorrow, Amarel High School and Junior High, the Bible Middle School, the BIC High School and Junior High, Gosnell Elementary High School, Junior High, MacArthur Junior High, Manila High School, Manila Junior High, and the NSF Tiny Diamonds. That's just to name a few. So tomorrow night, 6 o'clock, here at J.W. Ray Stadium, the Cheer for the Cure. Be here.
Fans getting ready to kick off the second half of football here. Number 18 for the Pirates set to kick off, Elijah Donaldson. Beautiful pick by Donaldson. That'll be a touchback. Wildcats have started off first and 10 from their own 20. Pirate defense taking the field here. Mental game, but it's a flag on the play, holding against the Wildcats. That'll bring them back 5 yards and replay the first down. So move the ball back to the 11-yard line. So first and about 20. Having on the carry. Brought down by number 56, Javonte Williams. Lost in the play. It'll be second down and 14. By number 30, I must say, Peyton Callahan, brought down by, he's going to be brought down near the 23rd. Third down about 7. Third and long. Jerseys going to the ball, led by number 69, Charles K.A. Kennemore, and number 7, Makai King, and number 8, Xavier Lewis. Fourth and long for the Wildcats. Kick out of bounds somewhere near the 40.
Good job, defense!
The referee's spot is the 32-yard line, so great field position for our Pirates. First down and 10. Cam Williams looks like he's in the game. Pass incomplete. To Cam Williams, down to the 25-yard line. We've got to see where the referee's going to spot it, but it's close. Third and inches for the Pirates. Floyd Williams on the carry. It's going to get to the 22-yard line, and that's going to be enough for Gosnell Pirates. Sound good, Pirate fans. Cam Williams on the reception from Shelton. It's going to be spotted somewhere near the 18. The 17-yard line. Second and about five. Shepard on quarterback keeper. That's going to be enough for Gosnell Pirates. And knocking on the door for a score with the ball spotted on the 11. Covered pretty tight there. Shelton has to keep it and run. Slides down near the 10. So it's going to be second down for the Pirates. Shelton to Cam Williams down near the 8. Third down for our Pirates. Touchdown, Pirates! Number one, Floyd Williams. Pirates will take the two-point conversion from the 3-yard line. Number one, Williams again in the end zone for a two-point conversion. 6:23 to go in the third. Pirates 20, Wildcats 6. How about them Pirates? Donaldson set to kick off for the Pirates. Oh, kick by Garnison. Cuts back again. Pirate defense taking the field. Get them motivated, Kenmore. Three on the carry for the Wildcats, still on his feet near the 30. Brought down by number 7, Mekhi King, and number 27, Jason Shepard. Actually spots it on the Wildcat 32-yard line. Five, Eli Evans on the carry, gain of a couple. Brought down by number 57, Ahmad Turner. Second down and about 7 for the Wildcats. From Jake Osment, number 7, is number 15, Parks McNair, brought down by number 7, Mekhi King. First down for the Wildcats. The ball started on the Wildcat 46. Wildcats go back to number 5, Evans, brought down by number 39, Mason Moore. Gain of 3, second down and 7, ball spotted midfield. Lays a lick, but there's a flag on the field here, and it's false start against the Wildcats. So it'll bring them back 5 yards and replay the down. So it's second and about 12. Pass incomplete. Well covered by number 8, Xavier Lewis. Third and long. Pirate fans, third and long. Number 7, Osmond and Perry, brought down by number 39, Mason Moore. Fourth down and long. Ball spotted at the 49. Let's hold them. Defense. Defense. Good job, D-line. Close. Good job. Timeout. Wildcats. 3:11 to go in the third quarter. Pirates 20, Wildcats 6. Pass complete from number 7, Osment, to number 15, McNair, brought down by number 39, Mason Moore, and number 8, Xavier Lewis, but the Wildcats get a first down, ball spotted in Pirate territory on the 40-yard line. Three on the carry for Wildcats. Katie Hatton, number 7, Makai King on the stop, but not before the Wildcats acquire a first down. Ball spotted on the Pirate 20. Let's go, Pirate fans. We need some defense here. Defense. Edit on the carry. Couldn't make out for sure. Looked like Mason Moore on the stop for the Pirates. The ball is spotted on the 14-yard line. Second and 4. Quarterback keeper stopped short by number 56, Javonte Williams. Third down, Pirate fans. Third and about 4. A third and close to 5 yards. Defense. Good job. Number 27 in on the tackle again, Jason Shepard. Fourth down and long. Good defense. I believe Shepard in on the stop again. Let's see where the referee spots it. But I think he's going, well, we'll see where the referee spots it. Referee, official timeout here. It looks like they're going to do a measurement. Pirates hold on. Pirate football. Yeah. Williams on the carry gets down to the 16. Pick up a five. It'll be second down and five. Direct snap to number one, Flores Williams. Gain of a couple. Third down and about three. Ball's going to be spotted on the 17. That's going to do it for the third quarter. To the Wildcats, 6. Your very own Gosnell Pirates, 20. Tipped and intercepted by the Wildcats and in for a score. Wildcats will attempt a two-point conversion from the 3-yard line. In for the two-point conversion. So, Wildcats 14, Pirates 20. Backbeat for the Pirates, number 8, Xavier Lewis, and number 12, Percy Wright, and number 1, Floyd Williams. Fair catch called by number 7, Makai King, near the 41-yard line. Pirate offense on the field. 11:53 to go in the game. Ball pops out of the pile, and the Wildcats recover. Official timeout. Ball nearly picked off by number one Williams, number three Williams. I'm sorry, it was number seven with a pass breakup, Makai King. Play down, I think. J.J. Lewis, he's okay. Up and running on the field. Third down at about six. Third down. Ball carried out the left side, brought down by number 56, Javonte Williams, and number 21, Sid Laura. No gain, fourth and long, Pirate fans, defense. Fourth and long, we got a hold of it. Pirates hold them, turnover on downs. Pirates will get the ball somewhere near the 40-yard line, 42-yard line. Excuse me, the 38-yard line. First and 10, Pirates. Roy Williams on the carry, off the right side, down near the 40. Second down and eight. Boyd Williams, and at speed gets all the way to midfield. That's going to be enough for Gosnell Pirates. Shelton to Partee. Got his legs taken out underneath him at the 47-yard line. Second down and about seven. Down near the 35. That's going to move the chains. That's going to be enough for Gosnell Pirates. And then some. Lloyd Williams, straight up the gut, down near the 30 or 29 yard line. Second down at about five. Number one, Floyd William gets down to the 25-yard line. Referee signals move the chain, so that's enough for Gosnell Pirates. Good job, Pirate fans. Lloyd Williams down to the 15. Referee's moving the chains. That's enough for a Gosnell Pirate. Pirates knocking on the door for a score here with a little bit, well, 6:59 to go in the game. Boyd dances all the way across the 5-yard line. It's going to be first and goal for our Pirates. Lloyd Williams, workhorse for the Pirates, gets down near the 2-yard line. Second and goal. Cam Williams in the backfield. Floyd Williams, I'm sorry. Defense was ready for him. So third down and goal. Ball spotted near the 3-yard line. Timeout, Pirates with 4:35 remaining. Pirates 20, Wildcat 14. Sides against the defense, which is the Wildcats. That'll move them half the distance to the goal. And that'll be on the 1-yard line, or right at it. Third and goal. Williams is in. Signal to the referee. Touchdown, Pirates! We'll attempt a 2-point conversion from the 3-yard line. False start on the Pirates. It's going to back them up 5 yards. This is for the 2-point conversion. two-point conversion. Pass incomplete. So with 4:34, Pirates 26, Wildcats 14. Donerson is set to kick off for the Pirates. Kickoff return carried back by number four, Coda Cameron, brought down by Jason Shepard, number 27. Ball's on the 39-yard line. Wildcats have first and 10. Power defense taking the field. Way to go to the ball, Pirates. Gets back to the original line of scrimmage. They're saying there's a flag on the field up here. Against the Pirates, another penalty. Holding. It's a midfield, first and 10 Wildcats. Three for the Pirates in beast mode. Riley Grisham on the stop. Second and 5. Good defense to the end, and there's a flag there. And personal foul against the Pirates. Ball's going to be spotted on the Pirate 40-yard line. Third and about a yard. Third down. Number 3, Cade Haddon. in for the score for the Wildcats. Coming up with a 10th block, or no good, by number 86. Score, Wildcats 20, Pirates 26, with 3 minutes 26 seconds to go in the game. Middleton checks in the game for the Pirates. Pirate football on the 44-yard line. Hand off to one. You better believe he had that ball wrapped up. 5-yard pickup. Maybe four. Ball started on the 40-yard line. Second and six. Williams on the carry, brought down by number 7, Osmond. Three, Cam Williams stretches out. And the ref looks like he's going to spot it somewhere near the 36-yard line. Fourth and about a yard. Pirates call a timeout with 1:47 to go. All start on the Pirates. Punt's going to get down to the 37-yard line. Our defense on the field.
Come on, D! We got a quarterback!
Hold on, defense!
Come on, defense!
Quarterback keeper, pick up about 8, knocked out of bounds by Shepard. Second and 2, the ball is spotted on the Wildcat 47. Ball slapped down by our Pirates. Third and 2. Pirate fans, 3rd and 2. See where the referee spots it, or he's moving the chains already. First down, Wildcats. Bobble snap, fumbled. Wildcats recovered, down by Shepard in the backfield, so that's going to bring up, well, timeout.
Let's go,
complete. Met in midair. Number 21, Sid Roy on the shot. Third and long. Wildcats have to spike the ball. Makes it fourth down and long. So 33 seconds remaining in the game. The Wildcats have one more chance. Show them some love, Pirate fans. Quick reminder, tomorrow morning, our Gosnell Elementary squad will be starting at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning instead of 10 a.m. So come out and support the Pee Wee Elementary squad, 9 a.m. right here, home game. Snap, Reed catches and falls down, so the clock is a running. That's it is for this barn burner. Final score, Trumann Wildcats 20, your very own Gosnell Pirates 26. How about them Pirates? Great job, Pirates. Great job, Trumann Wildcats. Great sportsmanship. Be safe on the way home, please. And next week, the Gosnell will travel all the way to Blytheville, Arkansas. Our high school team will travel to Blytheville. And our kickoff is at 7 a.m. Gosnell versus the Blytheville Crusaders. Again, children, be safe on the way home, and God bless.